So, in electromagnetic fields, vector calculus is an important topic. Now we have to see about the vector calculus associated with electromagnetic field. Whenever we are studying with vector calculus, we have to study about the scalar functions also. So, to the introduction to electromagnetic fields, first we have to study about scalar and vector component. Scalar is a physical quantity which is having only one magnitude, that is only one dimension will be there. Most probably it will be an amplitude, or possibly it will be a phase. Example for them will be height, weight, voltage, current, charge, energy, temperature, like that. Likewise, a vector is a quantity having both direction and magnitude. So it specifies in which direction the magnitude is obtained. So here it will be an possibly phase or amplitude to that of the direction. And over the scalar and vector, first we have to see about scalar, the scalar product, the properties of scalar, like that. If two or more functions is occurring at different instants of time, means we have to magnify those values using dot products. So the scalar product, which can also be called as dot product, is given here as A dot B is equal to, at the first instant of time, the magnitude will be A1 and B1 for both the functions A and B, and so it will be taken as A1 into B1, and for the second instant of time it will be A2 B2, and so A1 B1 plus A2 B2, and third instant of time is also added up, and so plus A3 B3, the same instant of time, the occurrence over the particular instant of time has to be considered. So that A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3, like that. If a function repeats over the time, means it should be squared or multiplied itself. So A dot A will be taken as A1 square plus A2 square plus A3 square, like that, which will give you A square value itself. So the properties of scalar function, that is the scalar product or dot product, will satisfies with all the multiplication properties like commutation, distribution, and scalar multiplication. So commutation means A dot B will be equal to B dot A, like the distribution law means A dot B plus C equal to A dot B plus A dot C, like that scalar multiplication lambda A dot B, where the lambda is a scalar value, will give the same value as like that of the dot product with the multiplication of that particular value. So lambda into A dot B equal to A dot lambda B. Scalar product has also another property called orthonormal property. Over the orthonormal property, if two vectors are at a different instant of time having some directional component 90 degree, means if it is multiplied with dot product, means the vector components will be cancelled and the scalar output will be there. So it gives only zero value, because scalar means there won't be any direction. Directional component is not there. If two functions which are opposite to each other in its directional manner has to be considered, means as there is no directional component, it will be considered as zero value. So the two vectors which are at right angle is considered over here, means it gives us zero value. A dot B will be zero. So here the vectors are said to be orthogonal, neither has a component in the direction of the other. If it is in the same direction, then only it will be considered. If it is in the opposite direction or any other direction, means it won't be considered. And so only for all other directions other than the direction to be considered, that is only magnitude is considered over scalar products, no direction will be considered. And so I dot I, the same direction, J dot J, the same direction corresponding to Y, K dot K, the same direction corresponding to Z, will be equal to 1, because in three-dimensional view we considered X, Y, Z. I corresponds to X direction, J corresponds to Y direction, K corresponds to Z direction. If the direction changes, it will give zero value. So I dot J equal to J dot K equal to K dot I equal to 0. If direction changes, there will be no scalar component, and so it will be zero. Like that, now we have to see vector component. Before that, we have to know why we have to study about the vectors. we have to study about the vectors because we have to study about the vectors because both electric and magnetic fields are directional components, and whenever two equal and opposite charges are placed apart, if the both charges are having same amplitude, means they repel each other. So the repulsion direction, opposite outward direction will be there. The vector component with outward direction is there. And if both the electrons are of opposite polarity, means it attract each other, and so a force of attraction, the electric lines of force towards inward direction will be there. So we have to study what is the directional component present. For that only we are going for vectors, and over the vector we have to study about the vector algebra. You all will be aware of vector algebra. So vectors will be or added, subtracted by adding or subtracting corresponding components. So if a vector A and vector B has to be considered, means it will be considered over the particular instant of time. So A1 plus B1, A2 plus B2, A3 plus B3, the corresponding function has to be added or subtracted. So the addition and the subtraction gives addition follows the parallelogram construction which is given over here. If two vectors A and B has been given, means the third one will be the resultant one, which is A plus B. And if it is subtracted, means it should be considered as the resultant one as A minus B. And unit vector is also there. Unit vector is having the formula A vector is equal to the vector divided by the magnitude of the vector. We know if three components x, y, z has been present, means the magnitude is taken by taking the modulus as root of x square plus y square plus z square, like that. So that is the unit vector. So like that, if we see with the multiplication with the vector, it should be called as vector product or cross product. So as it is having the components in different instant of time, it should be the vector product should be taken as A cross B equal to, if one direction, if 2 and 3, the axis 2 and 3 gives the resultant in the opposite direction. As in the vector addition, we have seen that 2, A and B gives the resultant in the opposite direction. Like that here also, A cross B equal to, for first instant over x direction, that is I direction, I corresponds to x. So over I direction, there is no component of the first instant. So A2 B3 minus A3 B2 will be there. Like that, over J, second component won't be there. So A3 B1 minus A1 B3 is there. Like that, in K component, third component is not there. So A1 B2 minus A2 B1. So if you cannot remember this, means you can use pseudo determinant. So A cross B equal to modulus of IJK A1 A2 A3 B1 B2 B3. So this is a well defined one to use easily. So where the top rows consist of vectors, not scalars. The top row is vectors, and below that just the values has been given. It will be multiplied the determinant value. Whenever we find the determinant value, we can get the magnitude over each other directions. So a determinant with the two equal rows has zero value. So A cross A will be zero. We know this as it is one of the rule of determinant functions. So if two equal rows has been present, means it will be equal to zero. So it is easily verified as with the distributive law, A cross B dot A is equal to A cross B dot B equal to zero. So that A cross B is orthogonal to both A and B. So as I already told you, orthogonal means normal component which is having 90 degree. So A cross A is only 0. The component present at the same line, determinant value. Whenever we find the determinant value, we can get the magnitude over each other directions. So a determinant with the two equal rows has 0 value. So A cross A will be 0. We know this as it is one of the rule of determinant functions. So if two equal rows has been present, means it will be equal to zero. So it is easily verified as with the distributive law, A cross B dot A is equal to A cross B dot B equal to zero. So that A cross B is orthogonal to both A and B. So as I already told you, orthogonal means normal component which is having 90 degree. So A cross A is only 0. The component present at the same line gives you 0 value. there is rotation at the same value. Rotation of the same value means repetition of same vector value gives a zero value. If it is orthogonal means it will give value for A and B. So like that, A and B means, so we can write A cross B equal to AB sin theta. To find the magnitude of the vector product, it will be considered as both cross product and dot product has to be considered. So A cross B the whole square plus A dot B the whole square has to be taken. This A cross B is having under orthonormal condition A cross B equal to AB sin theta. Like that, A dot B is equal to AB cos theta. So if we apply this over this A cross B the whole square plus A dot B the whole square, means A cross B the whole square is AB sin square theta, A dot